Hello friends, I'm Neha Baryani and welcome to my channel CECCBS. So today I'll be going to teach you about the terms used in accounting. So this is the second part of the video. If you haven't checked my first part yet, so I would recommend you to go and check my first part. So let's begin. This is the terminology of accounting, or you can call it as basic terms used for accounting. So while solving problem, you will see many of these terms used in the problems. So before going for the practical part, you need to understand the meaning of this. So let's start one by one. First is entity. So what is meant by entity? Entity means a thing that has a definite individual existence. Definite individual existence. It means that business stands apart from the owner. So it says that the business has its separate individual existence. Business stands apart from the owner. Business has its own separate existence and it is recognized by its name. So the business is not recognized by the name of the owner. The business has its own legal existence and it is known by the name of the business, not by the name of the owner. So business has its separate legal entity. Next is transaction. An event of exchange involving of some value between two or more entities. So event of exchange in the sense any exchange that is made which has some monetary value in the sense some monetary value between two or more entities or person or anything. So a transaction can be of cash basis or of credit basis. So cash basis transaction means suppose you are purchasing any goods and paying the money immediately or paying the cash immediately, then it is called as cash basis transaction. And suppose you are purchasing the goods today and you agree to pay the amount after 3 months or 4 months or after some time, that will be known as credit basis transaction. So transaction is nothing but the event of exchange between two or more entities or people. So the transaction cannot be carried on with a single person or with a single entity, right? So if one is the giver, the other has to be the receiver. So there should be at least two parties in order to carry on a transaction. So the next is assets. What is an asset? An asset is any property which is used to generate the revenue and which is owned by the business organization. It should be owned by the business organization. So for any property to be called as asset, it must have to fulfill two basic requirements. The first is it has to generate the revenue and the second is it has to be owned by the business organization. So suppose for example, you are going to purchase a machinery on the rent basis. It is going to generate the revenue for your organization, right? Because you are going to use the machinery for the manufacturing purpose. But you cannot call it as the asset of your company because it is not owned by the business organization. You are purchasing it on the rent basis. You are not the actual owner of that machinery. So it cannot be called as the asset of the organization. In the same way, if any property does not generate any revenue or generate any income for the organization, it cannot be called as the asset for the company. So the assets can be further classified into two parts. That is, first is fixed assets and the second are current assets. So fixed assets, what are fixed assets? Fixed assets are those assets which are going to stay in the company for a longer period of time or for a long term basis. So the examples for such assets can be land, building, machinery, etc. So these are all the assets which are going to stay in the organization for a longer time. They cannot be easily replaceable. So these are known as the fixed assets of the company. So current assets. The current assets are the assets which are used on the daily basis. They are used in the daily basis in the firm. So the examples for current assets are these assets do not stay for a longer time in the organization. They are also known as the fast moving assets in the company. So the examples of current assets can be cash, stock, bills receivable, etc. So stock it is also called as inventory. So stock is nothing but the goods which are to be sold by the company. These are the finished goods which are ready to be sold by the company, which the company is going to sell to its customers. And bills receivable. So when the company gives any or sells any goods on the credit basis, so it receives the bills. So which are bills receivable are nothing but the amount which is going to be received in the future coming days. So these are the current assets for the company. So next are liabilities. Liabilities are obligations or debts that an enterprise has to pay at some time in future. So these are the obligations or debts which are or the amount which is to be paid by the company in future coming days. So we can try to understand the meaning of liabilities by an example. So ICA Company Limited, it is an company. It purchases goods for rupees 10,000 from ABC Company Limited on credit for a month on March 25, 2018. So the ICA Company Limited is going to purchase goods from the ABC Company Limited on credit basis. So for a month on March 25, 2018, it is going to purchase. So if the balance sheet of the firm, it means the balance sheet of ICA Company Limited is prepared on March 31st 2018, so see the goods are purchased on March 25th 2018, and if the balance sheet is prepared on March 31st 2018, the balance sheet of the firm shows it as creditors on the liabilities side of the balance sheet, because now if not today the company ICA Limited has to pay the 10,000 rupees amount to ABC Company Limited in future days. So that will be the liability or that will be the obligation which has to be paid by the ICA Company Limited. Hence it is shown as creditors on the liability side of the balance sheet. So another example, if a firm takes a loan for a period of 3 years from a bank, suppose any firm is taking the loan for a period of 3 years from a bank or any organization, this will also be shown on the liability side of the balance sheet, because loan is also a liability to the company, because now if not today in future coming days that loan amount has to be paid by the company, so it is also a liability to the company. It will also be shown on the liability side of the balance sheet of the firm. So the liabilities can be further divided into long term liabilities and short term liabilities. So what are long term liabilities? Long term liabilities are those which are usually paid after a period of 1 year. So this is the amount which is to be paid after 1 year or more than 1 year. The examples of long term liabilities can be loans, debentures, or bonds. So loans can be taken from any bank or any other institution, monetary institutions. Debentures, when any company faces the deficiency in the capital or insufficiency in the capital, the company issues certain debentures to the public. So they are also called as the long-term loan for the company. And also the bonds. The companies also issues bonds to the general public in order to collect the capital required by the company from the general public. Short-term liabilities. So short-term liabilities are the liabilities which are to be paid by the company within the span of 1 year. So it is the amount which has to be completely paid by the company within the completion of 1 year. So the examples of short-term liabilities can be creditors, bills payable, bank overdraft, etc.
So creditors means when we purchase any goods from the suppliers on the credit basis and we agree to pay the amount in the future, they are called as our creditors. Bills payable. In the same way, when we make any credit purchase transaction, we have the supplier will give you certain kind of bill. So the amount present in the bill which that has to be paid by the company in the future coming days. So bank overdraft. Bank overdraft means when we withdraw the money from the bank and if it is more than the money deposited by us in the bank will give us a short term loan. That will be known as the bank overdraft. It is also a short term liability to the firm. So next is capital. So capital means amount invested by the owner in the firm is known as capital. So when any person willing to start a business, he has to bring certain amount into the business. That will be known as capital. So it may be brought in the form of cash or asset by the owner. So it can be in the form of cash or any asset. Asset in the sense any machinery or any furniture, land, building which are to be used in the process of manufacturing or in the process of carrying the business activities, they will be called as the capital. So remember one thing, the capital has to be brought by the owner itself. In case the amount is brought by any other bank or any other institutions or from friends or family, that cannot be called as the capital of the organization. So that will be known as the loan for the organization. So capital is brought only by the owner. So for a business, capital is a liability. It is a liability because the owner and the business are two separate entities. As I said before, the business has its own separate legal entity. It will not be known by the name of the owner. It will be known by the name of the business. So it is the liability for the firm because the capital amount at last has to be paid by the company to the owner. It has to be given back to the owner. So it is also a liability. It is also shown on the liability side of the balance sheet. In the company's balance sheet, the capital will also be shown on the liability side of the balance sheet. And the next is sales. So sales are total revenue from goods or services sold or provided to the customer. So when any company makes any sales of goods or provide any services to its customer, they will receive certain kind of income. That will be known as the revenue or that will be known as the sales amount. So the sales may be cash sales or credit sales. So again, if the amount is immediately received after the goods are sold or the services are provided, that will be known as the cash sales. So if the amount is not immediately received but it is promised to pay in the future days, that will be known as credit sales. Next is revenues. These are the amounts of the business earned by selling its products or providing services to the customer. These are the amounts of the business earned by selling its products or providing the services. So as I said earlier, in the sales, it is the revenue by which the company earns, or it is the income which the company earns by selling its products or by providing the services. So the total income, it is any kind of income received earned by the organization. So it is not necessary that the revenue which is generated by the company is only from selling the products. The company also receives other certain kinds of revenues. They can be commission, interest, dividends, royalties, rent received, etc. So when if any certain kind of commission it is received by the company, that will also be the revenue for the company. If the company makes any investment in other organizations, if they make the investment in shares, they will receive the dividend in return. And if they make the investment in debentures or bonds, they will receive the interest as the return. That will also be considered as the revenue. So royalties means if any company has any patent rights over certain things, they will receive the royalty. and also rent received. If any building is owned by the company and it is given on the rent basis to others to use, so the rent received by it will also be considered as the revenues to the organization. And the next are expenses. So expenses is an outflow of money from the business organization in the process of earning revenue are known as expenses. So expenses means outflow of money. Outflow means the amount or the cash is going out of the business. Why? In order to, in the process of earning the revenue. So when the company wants to earn the revenue, in that process it has to incur some of the expenses. Example, if the company is manufacturing a product, there will be various expenses or the cost which has to be incurred by the company in manufacturing one product. So those all will be considered as the expenses for the company. But you need to remember one thing, that is, wages is paid to the laborers who are concerned with the manufacturing process or in the factory of the organization, and salaries is paid to the official staff, and the wages are paid on the daily basis, whereas the salaries are paid on the monthly basis. So these are also the expenses to an organization. So interest, though the organization has to pay various kinds of interest, like interest on capital which is brought by the owner, interest on the loan which is taken by the organization, so it is also an expense. Stationery are the basic items which are used by the organization on the daily basis. So these all are the examples for the expenses in an organization. Along with these, not only the manufacturing expenses, there are also many other kind of expenses which has to be incurred by the company. For example, making advertisement is also an expense, and also for packaging, the expenses which are incurred for packaging, branding, labeling, etc. In order to earn any kind of revenue, if the amount is gone out or the outflow of the money has been done, that will be known as the expenses for the organization. So next is profit. So what is profit? In general terms, we all know the meaning of profit. In accounting, the excess of revenue of a period over its related expenses. So the excess of revenue over its related expenses, during an accounting year. So when the revenue minus expenses is equal to profit, or when the expenses are deducted from the revenues, the amount that will be remaining will be called as the profit. So for example, if our revenues are of 50,000 and our expenses are of over 25,000, so the profit remaining will be, the amount which is remaining 25,000 will be known as the profit. Or you can also call it as when the revenue is greater than the expenses, or when the revenue is more than the expenses, that balancing figure will be known as the profit for the organization. So next are losses. The losses means the excess of expenses over its related revenues. So in profit, we saw that the revenues are in excess when compared to the expenses, but in losses, the expenses are more when compared to the revenues. That will be known as loss. So when we deduct the revenues from the expenses, the remaining figure will be loss. So or it can also be termed as when the expenses are more than the revenue, the balance figure that we call will be that we called as loss. So guys, so these were the few terms used in accounting, but there are still certain terms which are need to be discussed which are used in accounting, so that we will discuss in my next video. So please don't forget to watch my part 3rd video to introduction of accounting on my channel. Okay, so we'll see you in my next video. Till that, happy learning.